We live in a globalized world. People, places, and economies are increasingly interdependent and interconnected. Ongoing global challenges are impacting all. Solutions require thinking and acting beyond national borders. Young people want an education that is relevant to their world and aspirations. Global citizenship education can help us learn to live together in peace. It nurtures respect for all, a sense of belonging to common humanity based on human rights. It helps learners think critically, understand the interconnections between the local and the global. It builds motivation to engage and assume active roles to resolve global challenges and contributes to a more just, peaceful, tolerant, and sustainable world. Global citizenship education can be delivered in schools in a variety of subjects, but also outside of school. Community associations, authorities, the media, family. It concerns everybody. Education fosters global citizenship. When students learn about global issues and how these impact on their communities, when young people are given the opportunity to learn from each other, and when they're taught to respect each other's differences and opinion. Global citizenship education is most effective when teachers engage in participatory approaches to learning and are equipped with appropriate teaching materials. Global citizenship education is most likely to succeed when all girls and boys feel respected as human beings and are encouraged to participate in school life. We can all be global citizens.
Okay, so now let's learn about the citizenship. Now, what is a citizenship? Okay, so basically, what we know is that if you are living in a village, town, or a city of that particular country, then you will become a citizen of that place, of that country, right? But this meaning is limited. Generally, if we are legally belongs to a particular country and have rights and protection of that country, then you are a citizen of that country, of that nation. Okay, so this is the meaning of citizenship. Now, the citizenship is a thing which we can, there are many ways to get the citizen of the country. Okay, firstly, by the born also, by law, by registration, and by, being a resident of for the limited period of time, for that required time. Okay, so what the concept of citizenship? Okay, agar if you are born in a particular country, to aap us country ke citizen hote ho, right? But there are some rules, jaise ki agar foreigners hai, they are come to India, for example, foreigners, they come to India, stayed here, study here, okay, in many area, like industries there, or ambassadors for, but you know, because they are come here and study here, that doesn't mean they get the citizenship of India, okay, because they are the citizen of their own country. For example, there are some people, or students come from US, Canada, or yahan pe aake study kar rahe, yahan par reh rahe, okay, but they are not, because of that, they are not become a citizen of India, okay, because they are the citizen of that particular country. They will, they don't have right to vote, they don't have right to get a government post, okay, not even right to, attend any political things, okay. So, because of that, they have to become a citizen of India. If they want to do this kind of thing, then they have to become a citizen of India. The main meaning of the citizen is to stay permanently in a particular country. If you are, if you want to become a citizen of India, then you have to be, permanently you have to be stay in India. Permanently agar aapko India mein rehna padega to have the citizenship of India. Okay, so now the basic concept is that if you are a citizen of that particular country, you have to be cooperated of that particular country. आपको जो government है उसको always support करना है. Okay, you have right government से they also give us right. Okay, and in return they also want the duties also. Okay, when we are always in a proud of being Indian, right? हम always proud होते हैं for being Indians. Okay, so our first duty towards the country is that to serve ourselves whenever the required. Okay, जब भी required है to serve your country, serve yourself to the country, and in return they also provide us the rights. Okay, to enjoy the rights, in return we have some kind of duties also to perform towards our country. Okay, and a good citizen will never break the rules, will never do something that harm the country. Okay, if you are doing any kind of crime, then you will lose the citizenship of that particular country. Okay, so this is the concept of citizenship. Now the if you want to get the citizenship, then how we can get a citizenship of that particular place. Okay, for example, there are some students who come to India, study here for a lot of time. Okay, now they want to be stay here for permanently. So now what will they have to do to become a citizenship of this country? The first thing they have to do, they have to अपनी जो citizenship है for example US, तो when they register to be a citizenship of India, they have to lose their other citizenship. उसकी जो citizenship है वो उसको lose करनी पड़ेगी while they are going to register the registration for the citizenship. Okay, or they have to stay here for more than 5 years. Okay, they have to at least resident here for 5 years. Only then they are allowed to get citizenship of India. Okay, there are many ways to get the citizenship of India. Firstly is very simple, by bond. Second is by law, and the third is by the registration. Okay, and another is to stay here for limited period of time. अगर आप यहाँ पर required time तक stay करते हो, then you are able to get the citizenship of India. Okay, now by born, so it is very simple. If you are born in India, then you can you will get the citizenship of India. Now by law, so the thing is that your parents are Indian. Okay, for example, you born in USA, but both the parents are Indian and you all are staying in a US, then by law you will get the citizenship of two country. For example, first citizenship of US and second citizenship of India. But it is till you become an elder. जब तक आप एडल्ट हो जाते हो तब तक आपके पास ये टू सिटीजनशिप रहती है, एंड देन यू कैन चूज अकॉर्डिंगली अकॉर्डिंग टू यू आप कौन सी सिटीजनशिप यू वांट टू चूज. इफ यू वांट टू चूज सिटीजनशिप ऑफ यूएस देन यू कैन चूज इट, और एल्स इंडिया देन यू कैन ऑल्सो चूज इट. ओके, सो दिस इज बाय लॉ. Now by the registration, okay, you can also apply for registration to become a citizenship of India. Okay, आप गवर्नमेंट में अप्लाई कर सकते हो for if you want to get the citizen of India. For there are some principle, if you want to get the citizenship of India, then you have to break the citizenship of other country. Okay, and to stay here for required time, agar aap India mein if you stayed here for more than 5 years or 5 years, then you are also able to get the citizenship of India. Okay, now government give you a citizen only one citizenship, they will not provide a dual citizenship. Okay, it is either by the state or by the union of government. Okay, so this is the thing if you want to get the citizenship of India. However, as I said, if any citizen of India if they do serious crime or break any betrayed or any break any kind of serious rule, then they will lose the citizenship of India. So here the concept of citizenship is that, okay, from firstly we have to, the family is the smallest unit. After the family there's a village, then taluka, then district, then state, then a country, and then a world. Okay, so this is the layer you will slowly become knowledge about that. Okay, so this is start from the very first, the smallest unit of the society, which is your family. Then slowly you grow and you learn about, you aware in a come in a contact with the society and know things about the society, you society, your school, your family. These all are the things that improve yourself, and they mold and they develop your personality. Okay, they are the people who teach you about and to develop yourself and develop your personality. Okay, and slowly you also learn many things, you become adult, you become independent, you know, you will then start taking your decision. Okay, and you, when you become adult, okay, there are some duty as being citizenship of any, you have some kind of duty towards your nation. Okay, in return you will also get some rights by the government. Okay, so this is the thing of citizen, and a good citizenship will always cooperate in a form of, in a frame of cooperation, always be in a cooperation. They will not harm they will not do any kind of thing which will be harmful toward the country, and they always serve the country when it's required. Okay, so citizenship is, again I'm repeating, citizenship means you legally authorized to stay, you legally authorized to live in a particular country, and you has and you have some kind of you know, rights and a protection. If you have some kind of rights and protection of that country, then you are the citizen of that country. Okay, so here we are in the end of this small chapter. Thank you.
Abhar.